And so there it was, the last time we would ever plan a heist. Todd was going to sail away in a new boat, Sean was going to start a nightclub, but me, I just wanted to save it.
Please, you guys are a bunch of idiots, okay? I'm going to invest in the stock market and get 1,000 shares of Apple. It's what any sensible person would do with 100 grand.
All right, Mr. Buffett, if you're so smart, then call my bluff. I raise you 20.
All right, first of all, raise. Second of all, any genius has thought about how we're going to get in the house in the first place?
I will call that raise and ask any of you if you've even seen the size of that house. I mean, it's fucking loaded.
I mean, do we even know if there's anyone in there?
Yeah, I checked. They're on vacation.
I mean, we're just going to bust in through the window.
Who are you, that little Asian guy from Ocean's 11? No,
we're not busting through a window. We're coming through the door.
Oh, man. These jobs have been fun as hell.
Yeah. It'd be nice to meet up again, though.
No. I mean, after this job will be way too dangerous.
So, in a while, then?
How long is a while?
5 years?
Yeah. Sure.
Yeah, it'd be great.
All right. Hey, let's go do this thing right now. We'll split the pot 3 ways.
Seriously?
Yeah, let's do it.
Sweet, I'll get the
masks. Yeah.
All right, let's go.
Suddenly, I knew Todd had gone too far. Last time, he killed a man. I could not let him get away with it. Not this time. I was his friend, and I had to put him to a stop. Time and time again, I tried to remember the details of what happened on that day. We spend minutes, hours, reconstructing the most minute of moments. Fabricating the fragments which I've forgotten, I firmly fixed the entire event in my mind. The robbery, Todd's death, my life. I'm now completely conscious of it all. There was a promise I made, one promise that I'm still willing to keep. A pact made 5 years ago to meet. Tonight at 11:50, I will get in my car and drive to the alleyway of a rendezvous spot, picked out by 3 young men half a decade ago.
Cameron, are you crazy? You're gonna bring a ski mask? Yeah, it's the middle of broad daylight.
I'm not getting caught. It's our last job.
You'll attract more attention with it on.
Even so, I'm not going to risk someone seeing me.
Who's gonna see us? Everyone's out of the house.
Well, whatever, man. Just leave him alone.
Let's go! Police, freeze! Put your hands up! I will shoot! Do not move!
God, where's Todd?
Those pigs, they fucking shot him!
We gotta go back and get him!
No, he's dead!
We can't just leave him there!
He's dead! Do you hear the sirens? We can't stick around here right now!
Get in my car. I'll take you to the hospital, man. Come on, we gotta
go! That's not part of the plan!
Is Todd dying or part of the plan?
And so I went, making my long-awaited journey into that dark, dark alleyway. Sean would be there. He had to be there.
Man, I missed hanging out with you guys. The old gang, just the three of us.
Yeah. What'd you do after we split?
Oh, I went to LA. Yeah, I cleared my head. I set up a new nightclub, the Robber Baron's Inn.
The Robber Baron's Inn?
Yeah.
Jeez, you have changed.
Dude, let's explore this town, man. I haven't been here in like 10 years.
God damn. Where have you been living anyway?
I didn't move.
Oh. I thought we split for good.
Nah, I couldn't after.
Yeah, you know what? How about I just buy you a drink, man? How's that sound?
You know what? Why don't you come back to my place instead?
Yeah, sure. It's probably more comfortable than a murky old bar anyway, right?
Yeah, cool. Let's go.
You still drink whiskey, don't you?
Yeah, sure.
See, things haven't changed then.
Actually, this nightclub thing is really starting to take off for me. I had an interview with the LA Times the other day, and they told me that I was a visionary and inspiring manager.
That's really great.
Yeah,
thanks, man. You know, I'm just starting to get into the business, but I mean, well, what have you been up to?
I'm not really doing much these days. I tried starting a picture frame business, you know, capturing memories, but it didn't really work out.
Well, you know, if you're ever in LA, you are more than welcome to hang out with my wife and I.
Wait, you're married? I mean, that's great. Congrats.
Yeah, thanks. You know, I couldn't even believe it myself. Liz really wanted to come down and meet you, but I said I had to see you firsthand for myself, you know, for old time's sake.
So, right after the robbery,
right after Todd's death.
You just rushed out to L.A.?
Basically.
What'd you do after the robbery?
Went home. Watched TV. Wanted to see if anything about the robbery or Todd would show up.
You mean right after the robbery?
Yeah, basically.
You just went home and watched TV?
I mean, I couldn't go outside, could I?
You remember what the first thing you said to me was when you ran out of that house?
I would never forget something like that, okay? I said I'm bleeding!
They shot you and you went home and you watched TV?
I said I was bleeding. I never said I got shot.
You said the cop shot you and Todd.
No, just Todd. I saw him bleeding. I saw Todd getting shot. I was right next to him and the blood.
Told you were splattered with the blood here.
That still doesn't explain why you were bleeding.
He could not go on murdering. He killed a man. I had to stop. I had to stop.
What happened in that house, Cameron?
We ran out of the house and
suddenly, I knew Todd had gone too far. Last time, he killed a man.
So I put him to a stop.
You killed him?
No, Sean. He was shot, okay? I'm telling you, he was shot!
God, why'd you have to kill him? Where are you going? Where are you going?
Answer me, Cameron!